with 3ds Max. This video tutorial, we're going to be working on the flywheel, seeing we just finished doing, I mean, this is the fly rod, not reel, but we just did the fly reel. Anyways, so been doing some thinking. I mean, I can see people watching these, but it's starting to seem that the support where I do post these is starting to lose interest. Matter of fact, I have some people told me that it's really nonsense and it's not need to be there. So I don't know exactly where I'm gonna keep posting these at. I know it's gonna be on YouTube, but as for being on a certain Discord channel, I think I'm gonna discontinue posting these, just based on some people not wanting it to be there. So yeah, I don't know. So this is probably my last video tutorial for this Discord channel. Now, however, on my Discord channel, that you guys are more than welcome to come. You guys can check out my videos there if you guys want. But yep, I don't know. Anyways. So as you guys know, that we just did a reel. However, things was changed in it. I know it probably you guys it probably wouldn't matter if you guys did it the way I did it at first, but for some odd reason my model was not up to par for publishing. So let me see what I can show you mean here. So I need to check out the renders here under the flywheel. Alright, so what I did differently here is added more geometry. So all I did was I got rid of the edge loop here, and I select this whole entire edge here, and I scaled it down just about there, and then I select each one of these rings, and then I connect it about two times inside, and then for the inside there's about three edge loops going around this spot down here and around this one up here, and I repeat it all the way around to each section. So the sides of the reel are now more like this should be. It, like I said, was not up to par for these people. You see now it has more geometry around to support these holes. That's the idea. If you don't support them, remember I told you about the artifacts and stuff that was show on the render. So this is what we have right now after we did our first render. You see how nice and nice and clean this is? It's really sharp edges here. You don't see no pulling, no nothing strange, reflection, lighting, anything around that. So that's all I did differently. So now, as for the whole entire model, I have done exactly that. You see, now it is more cleaner. We don't see no weird lighting issues around the reel. As for the wireframe, as you can see, that it is now more geometry inside, and before it was 141,000 polygons. Well, that was before, but now it's 243 polygons, and a polygon is actually, let me see here. Let me just put a segment right here in the center. A polygon is right here. Each new section is a polygon. And if you select all these, you see it updates right here as three polygons. And this right here is an edge that you see in red. Now let me do something here because this is kind of really difficult to see through. I gotta uncheck that. See, now you can see the edges here. They're in white right here. These are edges. Each one of these, all around, is an edge. This is the border. See, if you click the border, it actually the whole border turns red. And a vertex is going to be these little blue dots. The vertex allows you to move the geometry around. You can do that same thing with an edge. You can grab it, you can pull it. Polygons and do the same thing. But anyways, you guys get the picture, I hope. So this is what our rod is going to look like. I was doing some thinking. We're going to start with this right here, and work our way down to here. So we're going to come up here, create a cylinder. Now we're going to start right here exactly. We have this little thing here at the end to make. So now I am going to decreate. I'm going to get rid of these. Don't need that. I just made that for example. But I do need to create a center here. Reason why, because you see more white down here, up here, there is down here, but this is centered right here. So you can see that this is centered. You can see the white line in the center, right parallel to that. That is perfect. So we can go ahead and collapse this to edible poly. We're going to pull this down like so. I want to make sure I get this enough geometry to work this. Of course, we want to actually put this right in the center. Okay, it may be centered exactly, but it's not adding up to the picture. But we're looking at a flat image, so, but I'm pretty sure that it's actually a perspective view. So we have to just basically just wing it where it is. That's about, should be about equal to the same. I'm actually following along down here. That way I got the correct shape. It's kind of really simple to actually do this part. Okay, so we can pull this down to about right here. We're going to need a supporting edge right here. Okay, create one more part here. About right there. Okay, we're gonna pinch that off. We're gonna create one more. Actually, we're going to split this like a chamfer. We gotta create these tight edges here because we got different color going on here. We don't want it to bleed through this side. We want it to be completely flushed with that. So this is the beginning of our rod. So now we can actually bring this into view. This. Actually, wait. Not yet. We're gonna do this part right now. We'll do the same with this edge with that chamfer. And then we're going to actually inset this. And we're going to pull out to about right there. Then we're going to chamfer this right here. And we gotta do the same for over here. Even though we don't see it, but we know it's there. Actually, I'm gonna do this. I know it's there, but we can't see it. I'm gonna pull this like this. And this is gonna be pulled right here. Yeah, it's there. We could see that. Now we see it. Alright, there's the start of a ro fishing rod here. Alright, so this part right here, we're gonna do another inset. And then we're gonna pull out like so. We'll do another inset and pull out. And we'll do another one. Then we'll extrude it. We're gonna go about right here. We'll bring this in transparent view. We're not going to do anything quite drastic yet with this. We'll get there. So we gotta put a new edge right here and about right here. Then we're gonna drag this all the way out like so to about right here. We'll do this side next. We'll inset this. Actually, not yet. We need to look at something here. This is gonna have to be pushed in. Then we're going to extrude it inward. Then we're going to do another inset, and then we're going to extrude this outward. Now, the reason why I'm doing this is that we have to have a placeholder for putting that end part in. Now we don't see it, but we know it's there. Okay, now we'll bring this here. All right, now we have these here to make. So we got like one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's about 10 of these. Or I should say 8. Then we do one more. So now, bring this down to about right there. Alright, so we need to create a inset here. And then we're going to extrude. So we got more of these to make. So this is about right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is probably where we 10 will be at. Correction, more like 11. Alright, we'll do one more extrude. Then we'll up to here. Alright, so we got that much done. Now the fun part is creating these. So let's do a quick save here. We want to select all these right here. and we want to extrude with as local normal. About right there, and this way here needed to be brought down. Matter of fact, I think we're just gonna weld that. Dang it. And just weld this way. Nope. Okay, so I thought it might work. Try to be a little bit trying to be quick with it. It's not gonna let me. So I'll do it this way. So one at a time. Might have to weld these too, because only down here has this extruding down here. I might have to widen this down here some too. So I accommodate the real mount, I think it's called. I think that is completely weld all around, from what I can see anyways. Alright, so now we'll save first real quick. So down here is going to be trying to think how I'm gonna do this. I guess what we could do is scale this right here. And we can actually maybe take all this, but right here. And we can extrude this down. Like so. And we can me turn this to two-sided because one side you can't see through. And we're going to weld back here. Okay, now I've got to create an edge loop inside of here. I'll just come up here in this top view and do it this way. We want to actually pinch this. Alright, so the next part to do is that we need to extrude this inward like so. Sorry about that. I'll come up here to over wireframe. The reason for that is because it's going to start clipping out. You see that? We don't want that, so. So we kind of want to help guide this to go in. Okay, then we're going to create an inset inside. Hold on a minute, that. Just like so. This way, it create a nice tight and inside. So now we're going to do this border part. We're going to put a segment inside as well. And then we're going to take this outer edge here. We're going to chamfer it. Then again, maybe not. We'll just take the outer edge right here instead. And we'll chamfer that instead. We need at least both three segments here. Wait, hold on. It don't want me doing that. Okay, I see the problem here. Actually, I don't even see the problem there. I don't know why it's doing that. It's only slept on the outside, so why is it? Be honest, I have no clue what it's doing. I'm gonna have to come over here, grab the smooth tool or modifier. There. Now you gotta do the same for in here somehow. Okay, we're gonna flatten this down. Then we're going to extrude this inward. Oh, there's something I forgot to do here. I don't know what. You can tell the temperature is getting more colder at night. That's why I'm having this cough, 'cause I sleep with the window fan and stuff, and it helps me breathe better. But yeah, I pay the price in the morning when I wake up from the cold. Actually, that's not right done yet. There's times I had to keep backtracking my steps here. I know it's like we cannot see inside this spot, but we know that it has to fit that reel somehow. And the only thing that makes sense is what I'm doing. Because this actually screws down, this is why that is there. Alright, speaking of which, we're gonna do that next. Actually, we got this thing to do here still. So we need to. Put this back into the default shading. Actually, I want to actually create a new edge in here. We're gonna chamfer. Every time you chamfer this, it does this. All right, so we gotta set these polygons and this polygon, and we're going to do that local normal. To about right there. And we're going to create a connect. To about 95. We're gonna have to chamfer anyways. Alright, we're gonna do a save here because we're gonna do something here. Now this is gonna be flat. Because this is actually we need to make one. Segment here. I'm going to grab this whole loop right here. This is actually going to be my great boy here. I actually want to flatten this. Then I want to do this. And now we'll do a edge loop inside here. This is going to be one. And we're going to pull this out like so. And we're going to take this top part right here and we're going to chamfer that. And we're going to chamfer this. Okay, so now the next part is which we're going to save. We need to do the same for this part right here. So what we could do, otherwise we're gonna have a problem here. We can actually take this whole part right here. don't want the inside, I just want the outside part. Why is it all triangulated in there? I don't remember doing that. Is it triangulated? Yeah, it is. Wow. I don't know. I don't want to select them. So we'll do it this way. We'll do a loop through here. That way we don't set the inside by accident. And then we'll polygon. Well, you know what? I'm gonna do this instead. Can't even do that even. I don't even think I can even do what I want to do with this. The reason why it's doing is because this part up here isn't detached. And I can't detach it now. maybe I could do it this way. It'd be more tedious, but it will work. I'm just gonna do this, otherwise it's gonna be more difficult. Nope, can't do it that way either. Just not right. I can't. Alright, I'm gonna do a save and attempt something here. Might work, might not work. Okay, I'm gonna try to detach this. And I'm gonna just isolate this for a minute. Hide this object for a minute. How come it's not setting a border? For God's sake. There, I don't know what the heck that was doing. Okay, now I actually can get rid of this stuff that's inside of here. I'm kind of getting really ticked off at this thing. Okay, I see what's going on here. Did I just create a hole there? Sure enough, it did. Just the one section at a time, I guess. I might not even, might just backtrack my whole step because this ain't working. It's not, it's just, get it. I really think I was frickin' messed up already. Yep, I messed up. God dang it. I did save this, I'm sure, before I did this mess up. I'm not gonna bother with it. I'm just gonna make it the way it is and not trying to make this as movable. I wanted to, but it ain't gonna let me do it. So, you gotta take these edges here. The same for these. Actually, I need to see something here. Yeah, we kind of got like a slight thing going on right here. I guess it's okay. Okay. We need to chamfer this here, and we gotta make it really tight. Like maybe like 0.3, but right there would be fine. Same thing with up here. Okay, now we'll grab the edges here. I'm just double clicking each edge. That way it automatically loops the whole entire thing. Then we're gonna chamfer. Like so, you know what? Undo this. We'll do this part last, cause this is kinda. Not the same. Which kinda concerns me. Huh, I guess I ain't gonna worry about it then. this one we're gonna do different, do the same way, but kind of more wider. So extrude. Alright, so now we just work this part. So we'll do a quick save here. Let's see here. I'm just going to draw a line right from here. That is perfect. So now we can work on down here. So as you see that it has a slight little extruding going on here. So from this point and this point is slightly extrude. I mean slightly, but like there. Okay, this right here is just going to be like a tube. And it's gonna be like halfway like there. Now I'm gonna isolate this for a minute because let's get rid of these height segments. So now I know where to make the line. I mean that. No, I don't want to do that yet. We're actually gonna delete this top part. Well, I gotta delete this too. Huh, why ain't this working? Okay, I think I can target weld this now. I should be able to loop this all around. And I actually want to see what this looks like with being subdivision. Actually, it's looking like it should. I gotta ring this. I don't want to weld. I need to connect. Alright, so now we had to build the next part by eyeball. I don't really have a good reference for this, the end part here. What I do have is this right here. As you see, it's very blurry, but I should be able to use this. That's kind of still blurry. Should we create this right now? No, definitely not ready for that part. We're like about right here. So, maybe about right here where the eye should be, the first eye should be. Maybe not, maybe further. I think about right there. So what we kind of want to do is take this section right here. Well, actually, no. We'll come to this view, this side. Want to keep just growing it. Okay, I think we're actually pretty good. So we want to actually grab that. And we want to make a copy of this. And bring that down below here. Then we want to grab this edge, pull this like so, and we want to come up to here. We'll select the new this part right here. And then hold on a minute. We'll undo that. We're just going to actually take all this right here. Now, make a copy of this. about right here. Like I said, right now we're at the point where we're just eyeballing this to the best what we see. It's hard to rotate this when you got only a small selection select. Okay, now we're going to select the weld tool. How come it's not welding? I know what's going on here. Now it should weld. Yep, there we go. This kind of makes it more easier, actually. All right, let me look at the picture for a minute. kind of starts to taper down too down here. Very slightly though. Alright, next is to create that eye, which is going to go down here. So we'll go bring it to view. So this is what the front eye looks like. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually grab this part and this part. And I'm gonna actually clone this. But as a copy. I'm gonna name it as object because I don't want to have be named as cylinder. Why did it do that? Clone to object. There we go. There. The reason why I did this is because I can make this eye the best I can to fit it within this thing part. So when I make the metal prongs, I guess you can call it, to be inside of here, so which will affect the actual rod. So we're going to do the eye. So up here we grab the tube right here in the center. So we want to bring this down. I is actually more larger than the more wider than the rod itself. So there's two. One, there's a one good way we can actually do this. We can collapse this. Select the edible poly, and we could take one whole section like this, so, and we can delete it. Now the reason why I did this is you see it here on the side that we have this part. So we're gonna have to here and connect. Then we want to trying to figure out how I'm gonna do this. We'll come up here, grab the line tool. I do a quick save here. Let's see how this goes. We want to extrude this along this line. We kind of want to bring this down some. To about right there. Drag this up here. No, not yet. This line's gotta be just some more. Alright, check, see what it looks like now. I might be able to work with this. Okay, I can just ring this and all right, I still need to do one more thing here. Need to split this section here. Then I want to go up here and delete. Move this pivot here. I want to symmetry this whole section. Make sure there's no gap there. Okay, collapse. I want to make sure I repeat the same side. What the heck's going on here? I'll worry about it here in a second. I'll fix it. Actually, I gotta see what's going on here. There should be a polygon here, and it should not be gone. How's that crate tool at? Creating this inside should not be too hard. It's a border. I'm gonna have to just hide it. The rest of this need a just do one at a time. Or maybe I don't have to. Let me see if this works this way. Okay, so it's gonna work. See if I can do this loop thing here. It's not welded. Okay, I see what's going on here. There's gotta be another side here not welded. Now let's see if it'll let me connect this. There we go. One thing, sir, I'm just going to make a copy of this, so I have to do this again. Okay, it's not letting me bridge this. I might have stuck the wrong edge too. Probably be something here that's not welded too. Now there's four of these, there should be more that's not welded. Now that should be the last one. Well, four of these already. Okay, now I should be able to loop this. Nope. Why is it not letting me? Something is not welded still. Something wasn't welded, I don't know what it was, but something. That means I gotta do the same for over here then. Oh, never mind. I actually did loop all around. So I need two of these in here. So about right there. So I want to take this center part. See, Mernite now is making this inside part right here. So we're going to extrude along the local normal. Hold on, there's something not welded here. I've missed one. Let's see if this will let me do this. There we go. I should be using the bevel. What this actually does, it does like what it's like you think it would do. So I'm gonna take all these outer edges here. I wanna chamfer these. Not much, just very slightly. These ends can be deleted because they're going to be hidden anyways. So now we gotta do on the sides here. Then we need to ring the whole entire thing. Now, there's also, if I'm correct, that there should be something also here around the edges. So, these right here going to be extruded out just slightly. So now it should look like it, like it's supposed to. Then again, that edge right there ain't gonna work. I'm gonna have to remove that inside part I just did. I can still do this part though. Can't even pull that out. Now the inside of the eye isn't flat. That's how the line actually glides too easily, so I did not do a good enough closure here. Now it should look good. I still want to straighten these out a little bit because they're not bent like that. Why is it not looping? Is it not welded or what is it going on here? Oh. Weird. Oh, I know why. Okay, now I can take this object and delete it. And I'll push this up a bit. Now I gotta do the same for this side. How the heck did I do the other side? Well, I kind of like how it did the other side somehow. I'll just do it this way then. Is this not centered, or what is this going on here? Ah, you know what? I'm just gonna do this. I bet this is why this is doing this. It ain't nothing to do with the, with the eye. I could just do this too, I could shrink it down. Some reason did not like that. Oh, I think it'd be okay where it is. I feel like the eye is too small though. Alright guys, I am going to end the video here. We'll do part 2 here later on. If you guys liked the video, please hit the like button. If you guys want, you guys should subscribe as well if you guys haven't done so already. I thank you for the support, and I thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in part 2.